Good evening, or good morning, or good afternoon. My name is Damien Burt, and today I'm going to do a demonstration using the HTTP trigger action in Power Automate. So my aim is to demonstrate to you how I can pull the contents of a SharePoint document library onto my blog dynamically. I'm going to share files and I'm going to put them through an approval process, and then these links will be available to anyone in the world. So you might be thinking, why would I want to do that? Well, I think it's a common requirement to share documents to your customers. And quite often you'll need to involve your web team or an administrator of a content management system. And then there's the occasion where you've uploaded a document and you need to make changes. So you then need to go back to this group of people and make another change in order to get that document published. My proof of concept that I've built will show you how you can provide links to these files completely automatically using Power Automate. So I'm going to jump onto the demonstration now. So in front of me, I have a SharePoint document library and I have four files currently saved there. I've added a couple of extra columns. I've got a sharing link column where I use Flow to generate a sharing link. And then I have a description column where I take the response from the approver and use that to present the description of the file back to the end user on the website. I'm going to jump onto my website and I'm opened up here as a guest. So I'm completely detached from my own Office 365 environment. I've written an article here on how you can create this yourself. I've also got another proof of concept using Microsoft Forms, where upon completion, your name and score will appear on a dynamic scoreboard, which again is an example of using the HTTP trigger and a SharePoint list. So you'll have all the details here on how to set up your SharePoint site. You might need a SharePoint administrator to set up the external sharing settings. But if I just scroll down to the bottom here, you'll see that I've got an HTML table, and in that table I have four files, and those four files match the four that are currently saved to my document library. So here we are back at my original document library. I'm now going to jump into my first flow. So my first flow is based on when a file is created. So I'm just going to go into edit and we'll just wait for this to load up. Okay, so when a file is created in this particular document library and in a particular folder in that document library, we start an approval process. And that approval process is currently sent to my colleague Dave, telling them that a file has been uploaded to the external shared document library, and if it's approved, it will become available to the world. And the comments that he provides in return will be saved against the file description. And we also provide a link to that item. Then, using a condition, based on the outcome of the approval process, if Dave approves it, we'll create a sharing link for that particular file, and then we'll update the file properties. So the two columns I mentioned earlier in that document library, the sharing link and the description, are updated. If Dave is to reject this particular approval process, we'll send an email back to the original owner of the file to let them know that the upload has been rejected. So let's go and test this particular cloud flow now. And what we'll do is we'll jump back onto my SharePoint document library. So I just happen to have another PDF file that I'd like to present to the world. I'm just dragging it across here. And we can see it's loaded and there's no sharing link and there's no description. And so my flow should hopefully kick into action and send out an approval. And just for the benefit of doubt, I'm going to jump back onto my blog here, do a quick refresh, and we'll see that we're still only displaying four files. So now if I jump onto Dave's profile, he's received the approval request. So a link to the particular document, if I just launch that now, we can see it's the Power Platform Training and Certification Journey. So for any of those that are watching that are looking to do their exams on Power Platform, this is quite a detailed document on the various options. And so I'm going to get Dave to approve this, and in here I'm going to create a description based on the certification journey and submit that. So now that I've submitted that approval, we can jump back to our original flow. We can see that that flow has now completed. The branch has gone down the true result. It's created a link, and it's also updated the file properties with the description and the sharing link. And if we just jump onto the SharePoint document library, we can see that the Power Platform certification journey now has a link and a description. Now, if I jump onto my website and just do a quick refresh, that document is now available to anyone in the world. And if I click on this link that's been created for the Power Platform Training Certification Journey, it will launch that document in my browser and allow me to view that content. So here we go. This is the document that we were viewing earlier. But now I'm a guest, not logged on to the Office 365 tenant, but I'm able to access this file via the link on my personal blog. So you might be asking, how did I create this HTML table? Well, that's where the second of our flows comes into play. Now, jumping back onto flow, I have this second flow, which is based on the HTTP trigger. So when an HTTP request is received, and you'll see here you get a personalized URL, and this is the URL that I have embedded in my blog. I go and get the files from my document library. Now this would return all files in my document library. I then use the filter array action to ensure that if the sharing link is empty, then it's not returned in the array. And the purpose for that is I basically don't want any files that haven't been approved displaying on my blog. I then use the select statement to concatenate a row of a table. So I'm bringing together the HTML in order to create the shortcut link and the description and the created date and time of the document, which is what you see on the table of my blog. And then in return, as well as a cascading style sheet for my table, I return the table itself with the header row, and then using the join expression, I join the array, i.e. the select array that has all of the rows that I've created, and create a string. And it's that HTML that is passed back to my blog in order to create that table. So if I go and look at the run history, it'll make a bit more sense, hopefully. You can see the filter array here will be identical actually for both the inputs and the outputs, because on this occasion all my files have got links. But if we look at the select, you can see that an array has been created with all my links to all the files and all the file names, all the descriptions, and all the created dates and times. And then if we look at the response, we can see here what looks like the cascading style sheet and the HTML table. And here you can see the string of rows that have been created as a result of using that join expression. So that's how the solution works. I'm by no means a hardcore developer, but I'm using the Power Platform tools here to create a solution that hopefully has merit for yourself or your business. I think being able to present files that are available on Office 365 externally to your customer has quite some value, because traditionally SharePoint is an internal resource. The fact that this is dynamic, the fact that anytime you upload a file, you can put it through an approval process and make the file available to anyone in the world. It's hopefully something that you'll give a try yourself and potentially come up with your own ideas for the HTTP trigger action. Really quite excited about this one. Would like to get your feedback on it. And if there are any developers out there with thoughts or feelings about how I've done this, maybe want to look at my HTML code that I've created, feel free to get in contact. I'd really appreciate that feedback. And as normal, please like, please subscribe, please share, and come back next time with my next idea. Thanks for watching.